short runway.
The images of the Delta plane teetering on the edge of icy waters at New York's LaGuardia Airport are a scary reminder of the inherent hazards at one of the nation's busiest airports. With its short runways and proximity to water, LaGuardia can be a serious challenge for pilots, especially in dangerous weather. It's just the latest close call concerning safety at some of America's oldest airports. December 2006, a Southwest jet also landing in snowy conditions at Chicago's Midway slid off the end of the runway, plowed through a fence, and hit two cars. A six-year-old boy killed in one of those vehicles. In March 2000, another Southwest plane, this one in Burbank, California, also skids off a runway and onto a street. The plane hitting a car, just missing a gas station, injuring several people. A year earlier in Little Rock, Arkansas, an American Airlines flight also overshoots the runway, slams into a steel walkway, and comes to a halt on the banks of the Arkansas River. 11 people dead, including the pilot. Since 1982, there have been 23 fatalities, over 300 injuries, and millions of dollars in damage caused by overshooting the runways. Most of these incidents occurring at airports where the runway safety areas beyond the main runway don't extend a full 1,000 feet, the length mandated by the FAA two decades ago. Airports like LaGuardia just don't have the land to make their runways longer.
The problem is that some airports simply don't have the property. They can't acquire the property or they can't get the property to extend to make sure they have this extra 1,000 feet.
That's why the agency is now requiring airports to install a technology called EMAS, Engineered Material Arresting System, that can almost immediately stop a plane sliding down a runway. San Francisco had its installed last summer.
What EMAS does is it's a way of stopping the aircraft, creating as little damage to the aircraft as possible, but being able to stop it.
EMAS consists of a large bed of rectangular cubes glued in place at the end of the runway. As a plane careens into them, the cubes break apart. The friction between the cubes and the wheels cause the plane to stop. It's already been installed in more than 50 airports in the U.S., and according to the FAA, it's prevented 9 accidents, including this one in Charleston, West Virginia, where this U.S. Airways jet would have likely gone over a cliff.